and welcome to another big edition of RDFNL TV. Thanks to On Time Drilling Solutions. My name's Yeendy. I'm joined by Tara Murray from the Star Weekly. Thanks for joining us. We're getting ready to talk up some of the exciting things happening around the Lancefield Football Netball Club.
It is. Obviously, last season was very different for them. They decided, let's start from scratch. Let's go back to the local side of things and let's build our club from the bottom. And they did that. They got a few wins on the board. Obviously, Chris Collins came back as coach and he has been reappointed for next season as well. So good signs there to keep that consistency going. And now it's about trying to build on what they did this year.
And Chris Collins being involved in the club has been tremendous. And what we're sort of, the feeling we're getting around the other Tigers senior footy team at the moment is that they will improve significantly on and off the field, but sort of getting some of that talent and most importantly, just grooming some of those younger players to play more consistent footy, and that's been tremendous for them in 2018.
It is. I think they had a range of number under 17s players step up and play seniors this year. I know I spoke about a number of them throughout the season. A lot of time their best players were their younger players, so that's good signs for the season out there. Hopefully maybe get a couple of recruits as well, just to add a little bit more experience in probably some of those key areas. But it's on the up and up for this side that has struggled a little bit.
Absolutely. It has been a little bit of quiet in the news front sort of coming out so far, but I think the great committee that's sort of working behind the scenes led by Clark Todd and all the team down there have been, the feeling is that they're really building to something big, and we have no doubt that over in the next coming months, where they hit the training track on the 21st of November, if memory serves me correct. So if you're watching this afterwards, we'll hopefully get out there and enjoy the training on a Wednesday night. But we're probably going to expect some good things from them going forward. And realistically, they will climb the ladder.
They will. How far, we don't know. And probably depends on what the other sides do as well, because a lot of those other sides towards the bottom are looking to improve as well. But look, it's sort of only the only way is up for them. They did finish, I think, third last, so there was a couple of sides below them, but for them, the only way is up.
Absolutely. Now, let's talk about their A-grade netball. Obviously, not having a side in 2018 after making the grand final in 2017, but the important thing is the club is doing a lot of great work behind the scenes to ensure that they can appoint someone to lead the A-grade netball from a coaching point of view and get that list together.
Well, they have advertised for a netball coordinator and an A and B-grade coach, so that's good sides. If they're advertising for coaches, that's saying they want to try and get that A-grade side up and going, and that's what you want. You want every club to be able to have an A-grade side to make it an even more competitive competition. I think we saw probably the best A-grade season we've ever seen, and if you can get Lancefield back on the board with a few stars up there, it just only adds to that competition.
Absolutely. That's exactly what we need in the A-grade netball competition. So make sure you jump on the Lancefield Football Netball Club throughout their social media pages and obviously the RDFNL social media pages to find out exactly the details on how you can apply, because there's some great opportunities there to lead a young group of players to a great success. And as you highlighted, I mean, if 2018 is anything to go by, 2019 is going to be better. So if you get involved at Lancefield, and I mean, look, you just have to talk about Wallen's success. They didn't have a team in 2017, and they were able to finish third at the end of the home and away season the year after, building it from scratch.
Exactly, and that's what they showed. If you get the right people on board, anything can happen.
Exactly, and it will happen over at Lancefield. Tara, thanks so much for joining us, and we look forward to watching with great interest just how Lancefield Football Netball Club Senior Football and A-Grade Netball unfold over the pre-season.